Hi guys, welcome to my channel. If you haven't been here before, I'm Lindy, or otherwise known as Paleo Barbie. So follow me on Instagram, Paleo Barbie on there. And also I have a keto group now called Paleo Barbie Does Keto. So if you're new here, welcome. Make sure you subscribe down below and like this video. All right, so you guys want to talk to you about traveling and keto. I got 10 tips plus a bonus for you. And whether it is you are traveling for fun, like for just a week or something, or if you're going to see family, or if you're like me and in the summer I work away from home for like 5 weeks. So I had to figure out ways so I could stay on plan. And if you're like me and you're hypothyroid or any of the other autoimmunes, or if you have a slow metabolism or whatever, we girls who have all this, and maybe some of you guys, I don't know, I just know that more women tend to have it than guys do. It takes us so long to get the weight off in the first place, and also the benefits of how you feel. Why would you want to go mess it up in a week or whatnot, you know, while you're traveling? So that's what how I feel about it, so I try my best not to. Anyways, let me get to the tips. So I've got 10, as I said, tips for you guys. So, number one, bring your own condiments. So if you have access to a refrigerator or a cooler, bring your mayonnaise if you use approved mayonnaise. I use Primal Kitchen, some of you guys use Duke's. Whatever you use, bring it. Or if you can find the packet kind of it somewhere, do that. I don't think they do for Primal Kitchen, but maybe for Duke's, I'm not sure. Bring your own sugar-free ketchup, bring your, you know, that kind of stuff. Mustard's not so hard to find. But things like that, because that just that one little thing, it helps a lot, because then you know that you're not getting creepy carbs, okay? Or if you can't bring them with you, buy them when you get there, like if you're flying. I went to the grocery store when I was there for my 5 weeks, and I bought some things to keep at the place that I was staying. So I bought my mayonnaise, and I bought some different foods that I use, and I'll get to some of those in a minute. But yeah, buy or bring or whatever your own condiments. It will save you so much. Find keto approved freeze-dried food, which I'm not here just to like push my product on you guys or whatever, but it really, really saved me when I was out of town. We have these fancy little, so cute, and they're so inexpensive. They're like two something a piece. Chicken salad. All that's in it is cooked chicken, onion, and celery. All you gotta do is add water and mayonnaise. There you go, and it's keto. Your mayonnaise will add some fat to it. You can eat it with some flakers or pork rinds or whatever. And it doesn't have to be the chicken salad. We have, you know, like this is a jar meal I made, and this has got shredded beef, my seasoning, some green chili peppers, and some onions. And this was this is what I use for sometimes for burrito bowls or whatever. I just put it over cauliflower rice. So this would have been something I would have had at the house probably. But the chicken salad I took with me to work all the time. And if you go to some of my other videos where I did the 30-day challenge, workout challenge, I showed what I ate every day while I was there in North Texas. So I took this chicken salad a couple times, and I showed how to make it in those videos. As soon as I learn how to post those little links at the top, I will do that. But I'm still learning, you guys, so bear with me. All right. And then like our chicken, it also comes in big cans too. So I usually just make some, put it in a jar, take it with me or whatever. But we do have these, like I said, little baby ones, which are great. Okay, so that saved my life, the freeze-dried food. And bring my own condiments and buying some stuff. Three, look up where you're going ahead of time. Look up all the restaurants that they have in town. Fast food, other restaurants, whether it's like chains or local or whatever. Look them up. Find out what kind of food they have. Look at the menu. Make yourself some notes and use those notes to pick, so you know ahead of time at all these restaurants what you can eat, because that way it'll keep you from making a bad choice. Because you will be at a restaurant that you've never been to before, and look at the menu and you're with all these other people and they're ordering this and they're ordering this, it gets all crazy and fast and all this, and then you're like, forget to say, oh, I don't want, you know, ketchup on it, or I don't want rice and beans, or whatever it is, you know. So, or sometimes you feel like you want to be the oddball and you don't want to order off plan, but you don't want to like look like the oddball, so you know. So if you do this, it helps you to kind of stay on track and not to make bad choices. It helped me a lot. I have a second part to that in a minute. Number four, go to the grocery store when you get there. Like I said, not just for condiments, but if you have access to a refrigerator, or if you're staying in a hotel even, go to the grocery store, and if you have a refrigerator or a cooler, get a few things that you can eat for snacks, excuse me, to supplement, to take with you in your purse, you know, jerky or whatever you need to help you in case there's emergency situation, or if you just need to make some stuff in your room. Plus, it saves you money, guys. Why wouldn't you want to save money? Okay. Number five. If you're going out of town for work, or even if it's for a vacation, and you are somewhere where you can bring a lunch, pack a lunch. It will save you money, but also you can control what you're putting in your food. So, pack a lunch. That's my number five. Number six. Tell your friends, tell your family, tell the people at the restaurants. I don't care if you tell them you're allergic, like Dr. Barry or somebody was saying the other day, but tell them you cannot have sugar and you cannot have grains. Tell them it will make you sick, because that's not a lie if you say it'll make you sick, because if you haven't had it for a while, it will make you sick. It makes your stomach bother you. So that's not lying. So you can say it will make you sick. They're more likely to listen and make sure that your stuff is not put in your food at a restaurant. A waiter will, I had one a couple weeks ago. We went to eat at Outback, and I was very clear, like, I can't have this. It'll make me really sick. I can't have it. So he came, and he even checked it before he came. He brought it to the table. He checked it. He was like, okay, this is how I told him to do it, and this is what's in it, and I just want to make sure, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, thank you so much. You're like, he really checked for me. So if you make them, you know that that you can't have that stuff, that will help you. Plus, your friends and family, if you say it enough times, they're just going to, you know, be used to it, and, you know, and if they're not, then just roll your eyes and move on. Okay, that's what I do. Number seven, buy or bring with you your own creamer, your own butter, your own sweetener, or whatever, your MCT oil, coconut oil, so you can make your coffee. Coffee, if you need to bring your coffee. So that you can make your keto coffee, or either at your hotel, at your whoever's house you're staying at, or if you're working out of town like I was. I also recommend, I got a self-stirring mug, which was really cool, but the first week I was there or so, I dropped it on the wood floor and busted it, and so I don't have it anymore. I used it for a little while, but it was like gradually falling apart. But those are really cool. They have them on Amazon. But also, I recommend getting a milk frother. I know a lot of you have seen these before, but these are perfect for travel, you guys. You can stir up, and there's my dog barking. You can stir up your keto coffee with it, and have it with you, and it's, you know, it's easy to pack. And I kept the box, mine came in, so I just stick it in the box, take it with me. It's okay, peaches. Yeah, so bring it, so you can do that, because you want to have your coffee. And you don't want to, y'all, some of that hotel coffee is good, but some of it is just nasty. So bring your coffee, bring your stuff. Number eight, exercise every day you're gone, 30 minutes. I don't care if you go, like if you're on some trips, like when you go to Disney, you walk all over the dang place. So you're walking, you're good. But if you're just somewhere working or something like that, we tend to get a little lazy sometimes when we're away from home. So that if you'll go to my other videos about the 30-day workout challenge, that's one of the reasons I did that, was because I wanted to make sure that I got into a good habit for one, but also that I stayed moving while I was gone, because I knew I wouldn't do it. And so what I recommend is, if you're going to be there for a period of time and you're not in a hotel, join like Planet Fitness. It's super cheap. I don't work for them or anything. I'm just saying it's super cheap, and you can go work out and You know, if you don't have one at home, you can get rid of it when you get home. If you're staying in a hotel or a resort and they have a workout room, use it or use the pool. Go swimming, go walking, do something. 30 minutes a day, just do it. And the reason why I say that, not because I believe that you need to exercise to lose weight. I believe that, one, it makes you feel good, right? You feel better. But also, if you're on vacation, even when you're doing all these things and you're trying to work out, or you're trying to eat right, all right, there's creepy carbs, right? There's gonna be creepy carbs somewhere. So when you get creepy carbs, sometimes you don't feel that great, or it catches up with you, you know. And so the working out, I think, I really felt like it helps you counteract some of that, okay? So 30 minutes a day, I think that's a good. Number 9, before I left, I pre-made keto bagels. I made a whole package of bacon. And another week, I got to come home 1 week in between. So I made some the egg muffins, and took them with me. Now they didn't last me 5 weeks, but they lasted me the first week I was there. They lasted me, and when I came back in between, I had some for another week. So it helped a lot because I wasn't spending money on breakfast because I wasn't staying in a hotel. If you're staying in a hotel, we'll talk about that in a second. But it gets you on the right track for the first week that you're there. And you don't have to think about it. You have your thing, grab it, go, get your coffee, go to work. Go out, do whatever you're doing on your vacation. We've stayed at Disney before and I brought breakfast stuff. We've eaten it in our room, so you can do it anywhere. As far as if you're staying in a hotel that serves free breakfast, I would still bring your keto bagels or egg muffins or whatever, because we all know that those omelet things that they serve and eggs that they serve have creepy carbs. Probably the sausage or bacon does too, but I'd be safe eating a keto bagel and then add if they had a sausage or bacon, at least I'm only getting that. So that's my tip for that. Number 10 already, right? Yeah, number 10. Okay, and then I have a bonus. So number 10, buy gift cards before you leave for restaurants that you know you can eat at. So for instance, when I was gone before I left, and while I was there, I bought some gift cards for Chipotle, for Wendy's, for Applebee's, and different places like that, because I knew there was stuff there that I could eat. So I had when you have those gift cards and you're with other people, like friends or family, and they say, let's go to lunch today, or let's go to dinner tonight, blah, blah, blah. You can say, I have a gift card for Chipotle. Can we go there? Because I'd really like to use my gift card. See, and then you can use your gift card and it won't come into the whole, oh, you need to go eat there because you're on a diet, blah, blah, blah. She's on this special diet. Well, you could just make it about the gift card and then they won't even blink an eye. So that's my tip. That's my number 10. Buy gift cards before you go. You can even do that. There's lots of restaurants, big chain restaurants, not just fast food, that sell gift cards, and some of them sell them online. So if you don't find it in the grocery store or wherever they have all the gift cards for sale, look online because some of them do that. All right, here's my bonus tip. Fast. When you're flying, when you're driving up for several hours, or just when you're on vacation, if you know that you're gonna go out to a restaurant that night and you think, I wanna eat a big meal, but not necessarily, I don't think there's something I can't find there that's not keto approved, but maybe I might eat more than what I'm normally gonna eat or something like that. So fast for breakfast. Fast, do a 16-8 intermittent fasting. And if you fast on a plane and when you're driving in a car for a long time, I found that fasting really helps with fluid retention, because a lot of times when people travel, their legs swell, their feet swell, their hands sometimes swell. And I feel like that helps a lot. So that's your bonus tip. And these are my 10 tips, you guys, for eating away from home, traveling. So if you guys have any other tips that you might have, leave them in the comments below. I'd love to hear what they are. And yeah, so just make sure you like this video, you guys, if you down below, if you like my channel, subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you guys soon with some more videos.